Lanka store is soon going to be adapted as web series. He works as an associate marketing director at Oxford University Press and leads the social science discipline marketing globally. Our second panelist, Shailesh Srivastava, is a content evangelist. He's a senior corporate executive, having worked with large banking, telecom, and private equity setups. Before moving to media 3 years back, with Reliance backed Big FM as a business head. Mr. Srivastava has diverse and interesting views about social issues, politics, international affairs, and corporate world, and have been actively writing on social platforms and blog sites. Our third speaker, Anuj Tiwari. He is a TEDx speaker and marketing consultant settled in Mumbai. Anuj Tiwari was brought up and on the bustling streets of Bareilly. He studied in a Hindi Sanskrit medium school where there were no English books. Seeing the kids of his neighborhood reading colorful storybooks, he started building dreams of being able to read in English. However, he kept those dreams to himself. Despite going through 6 months of depression and severe anxiety and trying to give up on his life in college, Anuj Tiwari is now the best-selling author of 5 books inspired by real-life incidents. He has also been listed as one of the top 10 most influential authors in India from 2016. Our moderator, Bhuvan Gupta. He is a journalist with the Times of India, a management professional who gave in to his ever-enduring desire to pursue journalism. Bhuvan now writes and edits news stories for Times of India's Nagpur edition. I am sure we are going to have a great session. I will be reminding you with the help of a buzzer sound when only the last 10 minutes will be left. I now hand over to the moderator. Bhuvan sir, over to you.
Thank you, Nidhi. Thanks a lot. Most people would be highly conversant with the broad themes of today's topic. Technology has slid into our lives like a smartphone into, a pair of skinny jeans. Maybe cumbersome at first, but it has become a way of life now. In fact, I would say so much so that maybe if every marketer was given a penny for the time they uttered the words digital disruption, perhaps they would come up and fund a model that would challenge the existing pay-per-click model, and which has given the world clickbait, something which very few of us like. Books, of course, do not really have a way to bait us the same way the digital world has, and they've been bearing the brunt of that. Reading habits, have been challenged and transformed over the years. But specifically, the pandemic has telescoped that transformation. And who better than our panelists today, who've been authors, who are in the thick of it all, to describe this shift to us? Welcome once again, Naveen and Shailesh, on this discussion. Thanks a lot for joining us. Anuj, unfortunately, could not join us today because of some unforeseen emergency. But we open the discussion here. And I'd like to start, Naveen, by touching upon this very shift. Readers' habits have changed, but what has prompted this change? When the topic speaks of essence of reading, what exactly would you call the essence of reading? Is it the same as what it was, say, 10 years ago? And if it has changed, in what way has it changed? So yeah, Naveen.
So essence of reading, I call it pleasure of reading, basically. So of how we read, the way reading used to happen 10 years ago and the way it is happening, that of course we have seen a lot of change, and change in some cases is positive, in some cases it is negative. We have seen bookshops which are shutting down. At the same time, non-fiction book sales has been increased in the last 10 years. So initially, when ebooks were there, we felt that it is going to disrupt the market. Physical books are going to end, but that is something which didn't happen at all. And I remember, I don't have current data, but 3, 4 years back, it was just 3 to 5% of ebook sale which was contributing to the general sale. So still, people were reading, they were using the book, they always liked touching the book, smell of the paper, turning the page. Some people put bookmark, but I still like to fold the page which I'm reading. So that is something which was people, I think they miss. But slowly with the time adaptation, because the logistics, the cost and everything, I felt there is minor shift that started happening on the digital side. Ebooks is something which started coming up. And in the Corona time, we all publishers have seen a strong, big demand for the ebooks that increased a lot. So a lot of things. People are not now ready to accept the packet from a delivery guy. So that is something which actually started happening. Initially, 2-3 months of the lockdown, it was also difficult to deliver. So that change started happening now. And I don't know once things will be normal, how people will react. But definitely there is a change which is coming up in terms of digital consumption. One more thing which I have felt which changed a lot is digital consumption is not just about the books. It is also about the digital consumption of visual content. A lot of reading time is now taken by the visual content, the OTT platforms which came in, social media channels. They are actually getting a lot of reading time from the reader. So that is something which is also impacting the reading sense. That is something which is happening a lot in these days. If I speak specifically about the academic publishing, in that case, I think digital started coming 5-6 years back. In India, it is still in an early stage. But in UK or US, if you see universities, they are not buying books. They are subscribing the online platforms of university presses or the publishers, where everyone in the university, they can actually access one book at one click. So that is how it is changing. So that has moved, but still as a reader, if I that is something which I talked more about the market. But coming to the basic point, which was essence of reading, as a reader, I'm still very much comfortable in picking up a book, reading it, smelling the page. That is something which I always feel. And it seems it is not going to go very soon. It will stay for some time. But yes, there is some digital disruption which is happening.
Has it been something similar for you, Shailesh? Do you feel as a reader and author both that the essence of reading has changed but has remained the same also in some way, like Naveen pointed?
I think I see it slightly differently. I think there are three point of triangle, I may say so. One is convenience, second is access, and third is essence, right? By any standard scientific law, if you focus on convenience and access, actually the third point is going to distract. And that's what is happening in reading also. So that is one point. I think second is about are we being over-hassled or overly hassled with the fact that this is a change? Yes, this is a change. We have to embrace this change. I think to best of my wisdom, close to 15-16% sale is now happening through online medium as far as the books are concerned. But the fact remains it has opened a lot of doors. Imagine the kind of authors and writers, and Naveen, I know themselves are one of the finest examples of this, the corporate people actually coming to the fore and actually writing stuff, right? And that's what has happened in last 5-10 years. So obviously, one obviously is the change, but second is the avenues which is it has opened for so many people. I think third part is look at the distribution. See, we should try to understand that the essence of reading has to be encouraged, has to be it's a larger issue, because at the end of the day you have to believe that the publishers also work on a very, very thin margin, right? They have to pay to writers, they have to pay to distribution channels, and then they have to make sure that it is going across critical mass. Let me give you some sense on statistics. India, I think, published close to 90,000 books in a year. And out of 90,000, only 90% books sell only 2,000 or less than 2,000 copies in a year, right? It's only 1% actually, which are more than 10,000 copies in a year, right? So the problem which we are discussing here is a part of a larger problem, because the larger problem is that are we promoting and encouraging reading? And that is one. And second is that, are we losing the essence? So second part, which I will address first, that the essence is part of a change. We have to embrace that digital disruption is going to be big for all of us. And as Naveen pointed out, it's not going to be limited to reading. It's equally applicable for audio content for that matter, or for that matter, OTT content. 87% people in India are consuming OTT on mobile, not on TV, right? 71% people are accessing FM radio on mobile, not on a conventional radio set. So this problem is large because it's a part of change. It's a subset of a large change actually, which is happening, and we have to embrace it because that is how it is happening. And that's what I started with. It's part of convenience, access, and essence actually. Now, essence part obviously has to be done in a more of an ecosystem manner, because I haven't seen much of a, you know, say Pustak Mela or book fair in last 4-5 years in big cities, right? Second part is that, are we encouraging the habit of reading by saying that don't read digital and read paperback? That's not the way, because you clearly have to focus on content. See, ultimately it is content actually which is the big difference, right? A lot of people probably said 10 years back that nobody is interested in reading thick books, right? And you know, and we collect the suitable boy having 1600 pages. But Amish Tripathi came and actually he changed everything. And all of his books are very, very thick. It's still people read it, right? Ultimately, the fundamental point is how good is the content. Good content will always have takers. Right. The model, process, the structure, the form of reading can change. The fact remains, a lot of my friends actually was 92 scam, and they called me and said they want to read Sucheta Dalal book. The content is so compelling. Right. And that's where the beauty lies, because if you're what is happening in 5-6 years, I've won grievance actually with most of the publishing houses, and that I'm saying as a reader for that matter, that they're focusing on best-selling authors or best-selling books. They should focus on best books. I think that's what is more important, because unless you inculcate that culture of reading, right, it's not necessary that best-selling probably would be the best. People should read more. People should read diverse stuff. It's not only that the field where you are in, actually you are reading. So I think it's such a large ecosystem problem, which obviously can happen and which should be encouraged by virtue of doing many, many things. Essence of reading obviously has changed. It is fact. And you know, the cognitive effort actually, which you take actually in reading digital, as Naveen pointed out, and the topography of a book obviously is a far, far, the paperback is far, far larger than your typical digital consumption, but that has to be made public. People have to be told about it. There has to be a large awareness program. There has to be a collaboration. There has to be a lot of entities coming together and actually encouraging this culture of reading. And then we should also see that how government is overall supporting this entire ecosystem, because then publishers have to work on a thin margin. They also have to be supported. So I think a lot of people coming together probably would pave a path in this.
Thanks. This really puts everything into perspective so well. Especially taking off from your points on content and distribution, Naveen, would you say there is a correlation between the quality of content, however subjective it may be, to the kind of distribution seen on both kinds of platforms, offline and online? What kind of correlation have you observed in your experience?
One point which Suresh already said about publishing houses pushing the best-selling authors. I think the pressure is not just from the editors, it is also from the market. As a marketeer, because each year I always market around 120, 130 books, and I find it very difficult for a distributor to convince for a new author. And that is the time, the content, why it is very much important. There are two things which they work out. First, how big name is the author? Or what is the kind of content? So a lot of time when Kashmir, for example, I remember 3 years back when Kashmir, there was a lot of conflict going between India and Pakistan for the Kashmir. And that time we had some books which came up about Kashmir, and it was talking about different perspective. One talked about the youth, which is involved into terrorism. The other one talked about Kashmiri Pandit. So it was from all the perspective. And I realized, despite covering different perspective and the Kashmir being a hot topic, it was very difficult to convince the distributors about new authors who don't have a very, some glamorous kind of background to convince that, oh, please go for this book. So that is something which also comes from the market, pushback from the market. Booksellers actually want to stack those books, which people come and quickly they can buy. So they have just 2,000, maximum a bookstore can keep 2,000, 2,500 books. So they also try to keep only those authors who are very well known. So when you go to a store in terms of fiction, you will see a lot of Chetan Bhagat or Amish or in Ramchandra Guha in nonfiction. So that you'll see. But for the new authors, it becomes difficult. But talking about the content, it is something which is end of the day, we all as an author, as a marketeer, we feel content is something which really works a lot. This due to the online distribution, that is something which I felt started now helping us to push the content, where the content is very good. So there are a lot of ways for promoting. You have YouTube interviews, you have social media where you promote, and through the events, the moment people start understanding about the content, the way we can give them exposure about the content, what kind of content it is, they start picking for it. Not just talking about the other authors, let me talk about myself. So I didn't have any kind of writing background. So it was more of social media. I was using it to write satires. And through that, I started getting follower base. And when this book came up, my book, so that was not a political thriller talking about student politics. And it was not a love story, which any new writer, usually they write. So it was different. But the moment consumers started saying, and my book is not available in most of the bookstores, despite it is published by one of the largest Hindi publisher. But this book sold only through online platform. The moment readers started saying they like the book, what they like, and it started working on. So physical distributions, a lot of time it becomes challenge. The author name works. Whereas in online, if we are started, we start pushing the content. The online distribution really works for us. So this is what is going on for us.
Shailesh, how has the visual medium impacted publishing and books in general? Of course, the visual medium has, had a big impact on the other traditional players. But what about reading itself? Is that affecting reading as well?
See, I think visual medium in itself actually is a large piece, because again, we are seeing the change from a typical linear TV viewing to now a OTT viewing, which I shared with you, the 87% people actually in India are not consuming OTT content on TV, rather they are consuming it on mobile. See, there are three kinds of viewing in India. One obviously was a conventional family viewing. I think typically like what Ramayana and Mahabharata reinforced, that there is something called family viewing also, otherwise people are forgetting about family viewing. Second obviously is the viewing with friends, actually, which the content which you watch with your friends, close-knit members and something like that. And third is the private viewing. What we are seeing, the transition from first leg to third leg, because most of the people are actually consuming content now in a private mode. There are different reasons for it, actually, but people don't want to be disturbed, hassled, and they just want to be focused on that content. Some part of it is also to do that the kind of content they are watching, obviously, is not something they can actually watch in with family or with other members. So visual itself is seeing that drastic change of viewing pattern. The second part which you asked about, is visual medium actually killing the essence of reading, or reading for that matter? I would say yes or no, both, because see, you have to understand two things. First, when you consume content, actually, you become curious about the content. And sometimes it opens a door, that the way I gave you an example of Suchita Dalal book, right? And probably even, web series will also come tomorrow. Probably a lot of people actually would love to read Naveen's book also, I think, as a reverse integration for that matter. Digital disruption in a way actually is consuming a lot of time. You're spending 3.5-4 hours actually for that matter. And, you know, virtually everything we are doing on mobile or laptop for that matter. And now it is actually in a small screen for that matter. Either it is a mail, newspaper reading, or further any content reading, LinkedIn, Facebook, Insta, to a OTT content actually. And again, the very first point which I had mentioned about the convenience, access and essence actually, because you have to make sure that supposedly I recollect about some John Keats poetry and I want to read it. How will I read it? I don't want to get hassled by going to market and buying a John Keats book. So it's better that I search it out on Kindle and actually I'll figure it out. So convenience and access is very, very critical, which publishers and old school publishers have to understand. So whether by virtue of collaboration with the school, whether by virtue of collaboration with colleges, whether by virtue of collaboration with installing a different book fair. And again, there is no competition now because the entire industry is going through this struggle. They have to come together and actually make sure that this convenient access part is shorted. It can see until and unless you make the book FMCG item. Supposedly I want to buy a book and you know, I know that, you know, I will step out, and I will walk 100 meters to buy a book or get a book. Probably I will be interested. But if I feel hassled with the fact ki kahan milegi, kahan jana hai, then it becomes a larger issue. So yeah. I think this entire ecosystem has to affect. Visual media obviously has impacted the reading for sure. Just like any other thing actually, which digital disruption has impacted in last, say, 10 years per se.
Right. So Naveen, clearly, mediums have to coexist. They have to exist in tandem. There is no question of one over the other in such a scenario. For the ecosystem to be healthy, digital and offline have to coexist. Is there a way the increasing inroads of digital can inform how offline reinvents itself? Can books, the way they are written, marketed, published, presented to readers, take a leaf out of the digital playbook?
I think digital is coming in a big way. So the way reading happened and the bigger changes, we were looking for the kind of change it is going to happen in next 10, 12 years. But with the corona, a lot of things changes. And one thing which Suresh was talking about, the digital consumption, the way we consume content. One very interesting thing which started happening is audiobooks. Suresh is from radio industry. When they plan anything, they plan for the time when somebody is driving or going to the office in metro or in a bus or in your car. In the last 1 and 2 years, I have seen a good number of increase in audiobooks, buying audiobooks. So that is something which is also coming up in a big way. People, while driving, they are listening audiobooks. In metro, they are listening to audiobooks. And I'm getting a lot of Facebook updates. Through the Facebook updates also, I'm getting that, yes, it is increasing in the number. So main thing which I feel as a publisher, we just need to focus that the content which we are providing to the customer, that should reach. And we need to not to be just focused in the form of the book. We just don't need that physical book, which we are habitual of looking at it. We have to also think in a different way, the way consumers are accepting the content, the way things are changing, and slowly start giving it to in that format. So audio is one big one. Ebook is there, and maybe something on website reading that is just in the academic right now, but it is also something which can come up. In Hindi, I have seen a lot of websites, Pratilipi, which is working for the literature. There are something on Premchand Sahitya, which is very much available. So as a publisher, I think we should now just focus on the content, provide it the way reader want to get it.
Shailesh, what is the way forward according to you for publishing houses for books? Do you see a way where they can, you know, as Naveen just mentioned, promote young voices more and reinvent?
See, I think one thing is for sure that every medium is has to coexist actually, and every form of reading has to coexist, right? And as I began by saying that we should not be overly hassled, I think this is a subset of a large change which is being witnessed. And you know, digital medium, the paperback medium, all have to coexist and actually have to see each other as a companion for that matter, rather than an enemy to the conventional reading. So that is one. Second part is that, see, India is pretty large country, frankly speaking. 90,000 books being published in a year is no number, right? China publishes more than a 4 lakh number in a year. Imagine the kind of potential we have. We haven't reached out to B and C cat towns, actually. We haven't reached out to a rural India. Even if we talk about 50 crore people are right now a smartphone user, 70 crore people are not. 50 crore, next 50 crore, which we are talking, actually, they are only using the non-smartphone. Are we making sure that we are making content available on that non-smartphone also? Chote screen pe bhi you can read also, right? So I think India is very, very large country. We should not be hassled. I think important and bigger point is the culture of reading, right? Form of reading is a secondary to it, because some people will continue to do it because of convenience access, which obviously paperback cannot compensate, unfortunately, because that is how it is. But the fact is the culture of reading, culture of consuming good content, the right kind of and I frequently give this example of Ramayana and Mahabharata, when, you know, the entire world was being gung-ho about the web series and everything. Actually, Ramayana and Mahabharata all of a sudden came, and, you know, it got aired in Doordarshan, and actually, and probably they broke all kind of records, actually. It only reinforces the fact that the good content will always have a takeoff. Diverse subject, the political, obviously a lot of people have got interest in politics in last 5-6 years. And, you know, they are consuming a lot of content on politics. They are consuming a lot of content on Twitter. They are consuming a lot of content on blog. I write a lot of blog. A lot of people read it. A lot of people comment it. They want to read it more. Again, that probably they are more comfortable with digital part of it. But the fact remains, yes, the reading is definitely there. So I think we are living in a very, very beautiful country where, you know, still there are a lot of opportunity and potential to be untapped as far as the reading is concerned. That we should promote as a culture of reading. And then obviously form of reading would coexist. Some will go, some will remain and sustain. And that is how we should focus as a larger objective.
I think that's a very fitting way to conclude the discussion as of now. More than enough perspectives on how both can coexist, and ways for both to thrive may be different, but the goals are eventually similar, and content eventually is the way it should drive forward. Thanks a lot, Shailesh and Naveen, once again for this enriching discussion. Over to you, Nidhi. Thanks.
Thank you, Naveen, sir, and Shailesh, sir, for sharing your opinions on such a debatable topic. Thank you, Bhuvan, sir, for steering the conversation in such a beautiful way. On behalf of the Orange City Literature Fest, I sincerely express our gratitude towards your acceptance for this session and knowledge shared with us. Thank you all for watching and being a lovely audience. Special thanks to SGR Knowledge Foundation. The next session of panel discussion on the health of the nation, interconnection with the Indian economy and the democracy is scheduled at 2 p.m. I wish you all have a nice day.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.